Hello, everyone, and welcome to our 34th home time stream. We keep adding one number to these. We keep calling them home times, but at this point, I'm sure we've missed a very important anniversary of some kind on our streams. Needless to say, we have you for the next hour. We're going to talk, play all things Warframe, joined by Megan and Marcus. How's it going, everyone?
Good. Super.
Awesome. You know why everything's so good, Rem?
Why is everything so good?
Because Warframe launched on the PlayStation 5 today officially. The next gen build went live this morning at around 11 a.m. Eastern time. So if you are a Tenno that has a PS5, one of the people that had their hands on a PS5, you can play the PS5 Warframe next gen build. Check out the forum post Danny has up all about the PS5 version, next gen version on the PS5, about FAQs, obviously crosswind, stuff like that, still a thing. Check it out if you have any questions. But if you are on the PS5, tell us how it is. Show us those up to 4K screenshots. And let's just celebrate this great day for Warframe indeed. And for Xbox Tenno, you know, we don't have any information right now in terms of an X-Gen build for you. But if you have an Xbox X or S, you can play the Xbox One version of Warframe on that console. So you can still play it, but we are, working on something for you. No information just now as to when that is, so stay tuned on that. We'll let you know, of course. In a little week recap, Deimos Arcana went live on PC. That is going to be the next update, the next major update for console, which will also include Tenogen Round 19 Part 1. Very exciting for you. And of course, we've been hotfixing here and there on PC. Consoles will also be grabbing those so they have the most up-to-date build and is, you know, functioning well. Hopefully we'll actually get a hotfix out tomorrow before the weekend with some really important fixes, you know, looking into the affinity loss for Necromex on host migration, stuff like that. So lots of fixes in the works, and hopefully we can get it out to you tomorrow. And we do have Dojo quality of life changes coming soon. You'll notice some rollout over the future updates. And we already have some live from Deimos Arcana, so you can check out the patch notes there. It was based on a lot of player suggestions and discussions, and a great group of Tenno helped out for those QOL. So stay tuned for that. And it's still November. The contest is over, but you can still don that mustache until next week. So if you want a little fuzzy lip, you only have a little bit of time. The rock a mustache, all in the market for one credit, so check it out. And we do have new Twitch Prime gaming rewards, the Vyasa Prime operator accessories bundle. If you have claimed it and you have not seen it yet in your inventory, we suggest that you try unlinking and relinking your account. Sometimes that gives it the little push it needs to give it to you, or just wait a little harder. But check that out if you do have Twitch Prime. And we do have some Black Friday sales happening on Platinum and the Deimos supporter packs, and new winter collection in our merch store at store.warframe.com. And one of the Warframe knit beanies is actually modeled by DE Marcus himself.
Marcus, is it true? Is that your skull we see from the back?
It is the best angle of my face, which is the back.
Wow.
Yeah, that
wow.
is me.
Mm-hmm. Wow. And is that your angelic voice we hear for free on stream?
It is.
Oh, wow.
I know. Usually it's such a premium.
I know.
A couple more things before we jump into it. Obviously, don't forget to get your Quest to Conquer Cancer, Sigil, Glyph, and Conquera signed Dana in the market. Use the code CONQUER, CONQUER, for the Glyph and the Sigil, and of course, a signed Dana. It's 10 credits in the market until the end of 2020.
Yeah, we actually do, and this would be, if you're here for dev information, this is the part of the stream to clip. We have two pretty major things we're working on for improvements to the bounties. I'll kind of speak broadly on them, and we do have a dev stream tomorrow that we will talk a bit more about this in. But generally speaking, the first of the two things that we're changing for the Isolation Vault bounty flow is making it less prerequisite intense. So that means we're gonna essentially, once you've completed every bounty type once, the idea is that you'll basically have a cornucopia of options to choose from across old or new Isolation Vault bounties and respective tiers. So to condense that, it's basically we're trying to give you more choice instead of doing so many prerequisites. And additionally, the pit monster boss area, we are looking at making the rewards much better for those of you who go through that little puzzle. So those two things are a bit more on the dev side that you might want to hear about, and we wanted to make sure you could hear that today so that we can talk about it a bit more tomorrow as well. So there you have it. I actually don't have Bone Widow yet, but I think we've done like 3 buff rounds and there's still some issues coming, so we are working on Bone Widow. There's a few folks that have really dissected what should change, so we are still looking at Bone Widow.
And And there was an issue that cropped up from yesterday's hotfix of Exalted Iron Bride not taking mods into account. So if you noticed your Iron Bride is a little weak, that's because of that bug that we are hopefully fixing tomorrow, if we can.
We'll just say tomorrow. You never know what'll happen. Dev stream tomorrow. Yeah, it is a sound dev stream, but we are going to be doing general dev stuff from a sound point of view. And of course, we'll be just doing general dev stream things and stuff. So lots to see. Have to admit, some of the stuff the sound team has prepared is hilarious and amazing, especially if you like the sound design that went into the Necromechs themselves. So we'll take a listen, and then you can get a behind-the-scenes look at what actually went into making the absolutely bonkers sound design that is. All right. Well, we are going to send the love on over. We've done our prizes. Thank you, Marcus, for the top 10. Meg, it was a great time, as always. Best hour of the week. And now we're going to send the love over to Pocket Ninja. Who's
Pocket Ninja. She's fun-sized, and she's here to take your Thanksgiving night to a whole new level. So hang out with her. Send all the love over there. Thank you, Marcus, for joining for Top 10. Always a pleasure to have you and Gandalf with us today.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Could we get one more Gandalf before we sign off?
Sure.
Thanks for watching, everyone.
Bye.